Bercy Paris and to the first Grand Slam of the International Judo Federation's 2010 World Circuit. Many of the world's top judo players were in Paris to win valuable points in the IJF World Ranking List. On the eve of the tournament, Marius Wieser, the IJF president, introduced the draw in which the top-ranked judo players from each country are seeded. Bercy Stadium witnessed some wonderful judo over the weekend. The final of the under 48 kilos category was between Japan's Emi Yamagishi and world number two France's Frédéric Jossonet. Yamagishi won the contest in golden score with uchimata, an inner thigh throw scoring a yuko and taking the gold medal. So the semi-finals then of this under 60 kilos category, Sobirov of Uzbekistan, the world number three against Dragin of France. And it's Dropsy-Legi! Yes, he's taken the Frenchman over. And what a technique there from Sobirov. Right the way underneath. Takes him clean on his back, and he's through. So the second semi-final, Fukuoka of Japan in blue against Azambani of Georgia. Right-handed fighter, the Japanese, but he's got to be careful. Oh! It didn't even get going. And the Georgian, uchimata, and that was fantastic. And he can't believe it himself. Just look at that. Kills him dead. And takes him right the way over. So what a final then. Sobirov, probably the favorite of Uzbekistan, number three in the world. But the Georgian can throw, we know that. So anybody's match, and the Georgian there looking for the uchimata. Now, was there he scored? Well, that could have gone either way, but that puts the Georgian cleanly ahead in this match. Right the way over, and well, it goes to the Georgian. So the Georgian now got a hold on. So just 3 seconds to go. Sobirov putting him under pressure. But it's all over. Azambani of Georgia wins the gold medal. And what a great result for Georgia. The under 52 kilos final was between the top seed and reigning world champion, Japan's Masato Nakamura, and the world number four, Ana Carrascosa of Spain. With 1 minute to go, Nakamura chased Carrascosa to the ground and turned her onto her back before freeing her leg to go into Osai Komi. The gold went to Nakamura. In the under 66 kilos category, Sagambatar Hashbatar of Mongolia is the world number one. Hashbatar then, world champion in blue. To watch, he's got to be a score. Yeah, was Ari given, and he's well ahead in this match. The semi-final then, Hashbatar, world champion against the world number nine, Kim of Korea. Hashbatar, oh yes. Well, he gets taken back, and the Korean is up. Was Ari scored? So Hashbatar then, in trouble. Nice takedown there from the Korean. So this second semi-final then, Sanjishuren of Mongolia, world number five, against Larousse of France, home favorite. But oh, Dropsy-Legi there, oh! What a combination that was. Dropsy-Legi, and then Osoto, and then Kosoto. Beautiful combination, cleanly on his back. Look at it again. There's the Osoto, there's the Kosoto. And Sanjishuren of Mongolia goes through to the final. And he does it in style. So Kim of Korea in blue against Sanjishuren of Mongolia in white. And it should be an exciting final. So Kim looking for the Kouchi. Oh, well, Haragoshi. But it's outside the area. I want to see that again. There's the Kouchi, clearly outside the area, but no score given. So Kim then, for the grip all the time. Sanchez-Jaren, oh, nice drop Tsuyanagi there. But, well, he's got the cross grip. Arms over the top. Oh, now what's going to happen? Well, the arm was over the top, and you've got to attack immediately when that arm's over the top. Any cross grip, you've got to attack immediately, and the referees have come together. So it's disqualification for Sanchez-Jaren, and Kim wins by default. Favourite in the under 57 kilos category, the world number two, Kaori Matsumoto of Japan. So Matsumoto in blue against Vallejo of Mexico. And the Japanese has got her grip. Now what's going to happen? She's changed it to left. Oh, so did Sona Kamiguchi. And a clean nippon. And she's through to the next round. Matsumoto then against Loco of France. Matsumoto in blue. And she goes right-handed and she switches. Oh, there it is. So did Sona Kamiguchi again. Wazari scored. Lovely switch again. And she's so dangerous with that switch. So the semi-final then, Ribou of France in blue against Udaka of Japan. Ribou, left-handed, oh! That Uchimata was huge. And look at the crowd, they go mad. What an educated crowd this is. And Ribou of France pleases them with that. Look at the lift she gets. And cleanly on the back. Superb stuff. As soon as she had a grip, the leg goes in, she gets the lift and the ippon, and she's through to the final. So the world number two, Matsumoto, against the world number three, Ribou of France. Matsumoto in blue, and Ribou looking to take her back. And and she was almost there then. Ribou looking dangerous, but she's got to be careful down here because Matsumoto has got great newaza and she's just switched it. Looking for the osakomi, she's changed to the juji and she gets the ippon. Matsumoto of Japan wins against Ribou of France. So Ribou of France looked threatening with that Kosoto, but Matsumoto takes her to the ground, looks for the hold down, and then switches to the arm lock, and she gets the submission to win the gold medal in the under 57 kilograms. In the under 73 kilos category, it's one of the best judoka in world judo, double world champion, Ki Chung Wang of Korea. So Wang in blue then against Papu of Switzerland in white. Wang, so explosive. And he can come from anywhere. So did Sona Kamiguchi on the left. Wazari scored. So 2 minutes into this match. And Wang of Korea looking for his grip against Elmont of the Netherlands. Elmont left Ochigeri. Oh, and he pays the price. Ippon to Wang, and he's through to the semi-final. So with 1 minute to go, Wang just ahead in my eyes against Iwano of Japan. Wang looking for that arm over the top, and Uchimata. Oh, Uchigeri, there's gotta be a score. It's Ippon, and Wang goes through to the final. Look at the drive he gets off the Ouchi, and he grabs the leg on the way through, and he's into the final. So Wang, clear favorite in this tournament, but can Akimoto cause an upset? Akimoto underneath, drops Tsuyanagi and almost takes him back. No score given though. Korean coach there saying you've got to go forward. So Wang, he's got his grip now. What's going to happen? Is he going to go underneath? Oh, drops Tsuyanagi from the Japanese, gets taken back. And Wang's done it again. Another Grand Slam win to add to his three that he won last year. Brilliant stuff. There it is, takes the Japanese back. He gets the score to win the match. And who can stop this man? He's quite clearly the number one, and he celebrates in style. So the semi-final then of the under 63 kilos category. Bella Bordsey of Netherlands, the world number 2, against Iman of France, world number 7. Bordsey, oh, drops down with a seal eggy, and now, oh, she's got the arm, the French girl's got the arm, and it's Ippon. Iman then was quick onto that arm, and she punishes Bella Bordsey with the arm lock. She leaves the arm out for the Bordsey, and well, Iman just drops onto it, falls back, gets the submission, and in front of a home crowd, she's into the final. So the final then, Emden of the Netherlands, world number 8 against Iman of France. A minute in, and well, both fighters then told more action, and I'm sure we're going to see it. She's got the sleeve grip, so does Sonika Migoshi, and straight away over the top. Iman of France takes her over to win the gold medal. And look at the crowd, and she's saying, let's hear more noise. Let's hear from you out there. And my goodness, they celebrate. As always, the French crowd, most appreciative. She gets the sleeve, drops underneath, and takes her over for the Ippon. Here it is again, right the way through. And Emden didn't have an answer. And Iman runs off, and look at the celebrations there. Look at the tears, and a win in style in front of a home crowd. The highest ranked player in the under 81 kilos category is world number 4, Dae Nam Song of Korea. Song of Korea then in blue, let's guess of Germany. And the German there opens up with a drop, seeing Aggie. Song, left-handed grip, drops underneath himself, takes the German right the way over, and scores a clean Ippon. So 2 minutes gone, and well ahead, Song. It's Dominika. Song, left-handed fighter, looking for the draw. Tayatoshi this time. Beautiful stuff. So Song of Korea on great form, and ahead against the Georgian. Got the arm for the Sinagi. Oh, gets taken back though. Now what's going to happen? Oh, it's a strangle. Sikulari of Georgia has got the strangle. And Song can't get away from it. Can he get the leverage? He can. It's on and he's out. So Sikulari then upsets the odds and goes through. On the other side of the draw, the man on form was Leandro Galeiro of Brazil. Galeiro in blue, Hain of Germany. So, very stand, oh, whoa, classical Uchimata there from Galeiro. Galeiro in white, he has a beautiful Uchimata, lovely stand up judo, and there it is, and again, beautiful stuff, he hops it through this time, another Ippon. Galeiro, looking for the sleeve. So dangerous with this Uchimata. Oh, Sakeishi, oh, lovely. Oji Uchimata, Ippon Judo this. For the semi-final, Galeiro then, the man on form. He's the one, Ippon every match so far. Oh, Sienagi this time. So that'll probably put him into the final. Beautiful stuff. Stand up judo. So what a final in store then. Sikulari of Georgia in blue against Galeiro of Brazil. And opposing styles here. Galeiro, a massive thrower, we know that. And he drops right the way underneath. Oh, fantastic stuff. Bit of an overthrow, I thought. Hugo given, but rubbed off right the way underneath. Look at the Georgian there. 2 minutes left, but Galeiro doing all the work. Oh, he's going again. Galeiro attacking non-stop. And the Georgian, yes, he gets the penalty, and Galeiro wins the gold medal. Brilliant judo all day, stand-up judo. Ippon Judo, and that's what this game's all about. Galero then, a great champion, and the winner of the gold medal. World number one in the under 70 kilos category is one of the stars of ladies judo, France's Lucy Ducasse. Ducasse in blue. And left-handed fighter. She has the sleeve. And Osanagari! Oh, it's going to be a score. Yuko scored. So quick there with that Osanagari. And now, looking for the turn. And straight into the offside Komi. And Elazar doesn't have an answer to it. There's the Osota that sets it up. An overthrow. Scores a Yuko. But easily turns up and scores Ippon. Ducasse again in blue. And again looking for the Ouchi this time. Oh, Ippon. She's got the Osoto Ouchi combination. Either one wins. And that was a lovely Ouchi there. And she's driving Ouchi. Takes her clean onto her back. Ducasse of France then. Double Grand Slam winner from last year. And now after her first Grand Slam title this year. Lazarus of Hungary might have something to say about that. Oh! No, she doesn't. And Ducasse does that in style. What an ass she was, and that was. She caught her on the edge. Mezeroz didn't know what hit her. Mezeroz attacked, and as she was coming out, Ducasse Diashibarai and took her onto her back. Just have a look now, as on the way out, and it's textbook stuff. There's the attack. No commitment, no upper body contact. And she paid the price. Ducasse then is quite clearly number one in the world. Perhaps the best thrower in world judo at the moment is Japan's under 90 kilos fighter, Takashi Ono. So Ono then, two times Grand Slam winner from last year. What's he gonna do this year? He's a big thrower. Know that. Now, searching for the grip. Ouchigari! Oh, lovely driving. Ouchigari. The American didn't have an answer to it. So, Ono opens up the account. It's a lovely Ouchigari and he drives him over. Ono. Again, searching for the grip. As well. Oh, so the guy drops in Eggy! Oh, what's Harry scored? Oh no, well ahead. Looking for the Uchimata! Another score! Oh no, looking so good. What a final this is. Opposing styles. Oh no, the big thrower. But also, Juryev can throw as well. Likes to hug them in. Currently the number three in the world, Juryev. Oh no, looking for the big Uchimata, I'm sure. On the other side of that, Choryev. Oh no, doesn't fully commit, could get countered. Now then, what's going to happen here? Oh, well, he readjusted that, oh no. And he's taken him right the way over for the biggest Uchimata you've ever seen. Absolutely brilliant stuff. And look at that, he hops it in. Choryev tries to pull him in for the counter and he readjusts it and gets the lift and takes him right the way over the top. Brilliant stuff there. Talk about readjustment. Look at his left leg. Look at his head position. Look at the pull on the arm. And then the big lift. And the Uchimata was superb. It was brilliant stuff. Talk about readjusting your line. And Ono proves he's one of the best throwers in the world. And you can see here, the French, very appreciative of Ono's judo. And he's got fans all over the world.
The under 78 kilos final was an all Japanese affair. Hikari Ogata threw her compatriot Sayaka Anai for Koso Tagaki and Ippon. Ogata was champion of Paris and Anai had to settle for silver. In the semi-final of the minus 100 kilos category, Elko van der Geest of Belgium countered Georgia's reigning Olympic champion, Irakli Sirikidze, for Ippon. In the final, van der Geest came from a Yuko down to throw Russian Sergei Samoilovich for Ippon with Koso Tagari. It took van der Geest from fifth on the ranking list to third. The final of the plus 78 kilos was won by Russia's Alina Ivashenko, the world number four, when she beat Nihal Chikarou of Tunisia by a penalty. One of the stars of French sport is judo's Teddy Riner, the double world champion at plus 100 kilograms. Riner then in blue. And Zimmerman, his head's down already, so you can see how tall and imposing Riner is. Still very, very young, looking for that arm over the top. Uchimata, Wazari scored. So Zimmerman then, has got it all to do. Renner, well, Ojigari, Yuko scored this time. So two scores on there, and now after the strangle. So he's got the strangle, and the German now is in trouble, and he's submitting. Renner wins by Ippon. Renner, again, arm over the top, and the pole, oh, he's in trouble, it's a good score, so Renner goes ahead, so 2 minutes in, still no score in the semi-final, Renner, obviously the crowd's favourite here in France, and oh, he takes it back, and it's Ippon! And the Korean, well, committed to shoulder throw, and he gets taken back by Riner. Look at the power in Riner, and he's through to the final. So what a final then. Already two times winner of this Paris tournament, Riner. Two times world champion, Olympic bronze medalist, and he's not even 21 yet. So this man could break all the records in the future. And the crowd are going crazy here. Renner looking for the Haragoshi, but credit to Vijsters of the Netherlands, who is a former European silver medalist, and he's a handful, and he's not going to let this go easily. So Renner then almost gets taken back. So look at the crowd and the support for Renner. They wanted to win his third Paris Grand Slam. And Ouchigari, and it's a driving Ouchigari. And Yuko scored, and it's been waved out. So Renner then is doing all the work. Look at the drive he gets there. He pulls on the arm, didn't quite have enough control of the head. So Renner then, just ahead in this match. And another attack there from Renner. So he's got Vijsters, another wind-up, another passivity. And it's all over bar the shouting. The seconds then ticking away. And Vijsters knows that it's going away from him. The seconds then being counted by the crowd. And he's done it. Teddy Riner wins his third Paris Grand Slam. And one has to ask, is there anyone in the future that is going to stop this man? Riner, one of the many stars on display here in Bercy. It's been a fantastic 2010 Paris Grand Slam.
Today I was very happy for many reasons. First of all, because I always dreamed in fighting Paris and winning Paris, of course. Probably my mother's there at home crying a lot because she's so emotional. So.
I think I was very good today, and I want to win this tournament because it's in Paris, Bercy. And so many people come to see me. And you know that I'm changing weight category, now in 63. And I want to say that I'm here, and